So to recap, the Aussies get away with a 147 to 137 victory over the Cartel. Big win for the Aussies. They reestablish the lead in points for the season and squeak out the victory with Johnny Knox sort of sniping some points from Jay Cutler and Wes Welker just having a little bit of an inexplicable four-point game. So that was huge. Okay, let's move on here. We have the other big game of the week was the husband and wife matchup, which is always fun. The Whalers defeat, you got beat by a girl, 142-137. This was back and forth all week, all day Sunday. And, you know, with Matt Cassel being hurt, Sarah was forced to start Tyler Palko, who, you know, didn't have the worst game ever. I mean, obviously, it's his first career start on Monday night. Not much doing there. Did get a lot of points from Dwayne Bowe and would have gotten the victory had he scored a late touchdown when he was in the red zone, but threw a pick, got negative points for that to lose by five. Tom Brady had a good game, but not blowing up as you might expect against the Chiefs. So, but he got just enough to get it done for the Whalers. And again, Tyler Palko, one garbage touchdown late in the game, would have gotten the win, but unfortunately, you got beat by a girl loses. They're on a three-game losing streak. They fall under 500. And the Whalers take control of second position in the Mish division. So the Whalers really, that was a big win for them, defeating his wife, Sarah, 142-137. The big mover of the week was Third and Oolong, getting 209 points. You know, last year's champ was having a little bit of a tough time scoring the last several weeks. But they blow up with just everyone doing well. Nate Washington, phone's ringing. Where is that? I'm going to cancel the. Sorry about that. Turn my phone off. Where was I? The unsung quarterbacks for Third and Oolong, Matt Moore and Josh Freeman, really doing well, especially with Matt Schaub not only on a bye but hurt as well. So, you know, Doreen's going to need those two guys to do well the rest of the season, but. Ray Rice did well. Nate Washington had a huge game. Vincent Jackson as well, and Jordy Nelson. So finally, you know, all the receivers plus the running back and the quarterbacks for Doreen's team really scored a lot of points and beat a division foe, Ray Finkel's Kicking Academy. So they go into second place in the division. Tough loss for the Kicking Academy, only scoring 120 points. You know, had Drew Brees on and Marcus Colston on a bye. But really, Doreen blew up this week. Good job there. And taking control of second place in the MASH division because the Virginia Vikings, again, low point total, but they get the win. Steady Aaron Rodgers scoring some points. Not much else doing there. But, you know, when you play a team that doesn't score any points, it's a big help. You know, Frank Gore only with 9 points. Andy Dalton had a good game, but Matt Hasselbeck got hurt. Chris Johnson continues to just not do anything. Believe it or not, Rex Grossman on the bench got 26 points. But the Vikings stay atop the MASH division with a nice 118-96 point win. And good game for the Vikings, albeit low scoring. And back down to earth. The Travelers lose, only score 103 points, and lose to the Darth Taters. Nice job, Darth Taters, getting the second win. Definitely deserved that after last week's Week 10's tough loss. They score a very good 145 points, and oh my God, looking at the byes, holy shnikes. They had everybody on the bench except for Tavares Jackson was on a bye. So, wow, that's pretty amazing. Arian Foster, Reggie Wayne, the Steelers, Jacoby Jones, Hines Ward. So basically the whole bench was on a bye. So the Darth Taters get 145 points with basically starting who was playing. And they get the win. The Travelers, after a nice comeback to get to 500, fall back to 5-6. Still in the running for a playoff spot, but nice job, Darth Taters. So, you know, a lot of movement here, a lot of interesting games. The Slim Aussies and the Vikings have big wins, along with Darth third and long, and Hartford Whalers also with big wins. So let's look at the division here, because we're well over 10 minutes, but that's okay. Two weeks in a row for the blog. I'll split this into two video segments, and if you feel like watching it, you'll watch it. So I'm going to keep going. Like I said, Slim Aussies go to 8-3, have a nice one-game lead in the division and a three-game lead for second place, with the Whalers at 7-4, the only other team at over 500 for the year in that division. And the Cartel, you got beat by a girl, and all, and the Travelers, all with tough losses. They all fall to 5-6. And, you know, we'll have to see, you know, the last 3 weeks of the season if one of them can make a run. So the Whalers and the Aussies are set up to control their own destiny. In the MASH division, again, the Vikings not scoring too many points here, but getting the win. They're 7-3-1. Big win for Doreen and Third and Oolong to go to 6-4-1. And Ray Finkel's at Kicking Academy still well in it, only a half game behind at 6-5. Don't forget, the division winners both get the playoff spots, but the third and fourth playoff spot can come from either division. So could be the third place team in the MISH division, could be the third place team in the MASH division getting it. So no guarantees there that you're going to get it just because you're second place in your division. You know, looking at the points total, actually I misspoke earlier. Third and Oolong with that 200 point outburst, they have the league lead in points for the year. So that could be a tiebreaker thing. You know, just to show you how fantasy goes, have about 243 points more than the Vikings, but yet they're a game out of first. So the Vikings are doing just enough to win every week. You know, having a little bit of luck with having, looks like, the lowest points against, second lowest points against for the season, which is obviously helping their wins. So, you know, 3 weeks left to play. Nothing's been decided. You know, the Slim Aussies look like they do have a guaranteed tie for the division lead. But still, nothing's been decided. And, you know, don't forget, we have Thanksgiving games. We have Thursday games the rest of the year. So get your lineups in early. I really should know this off the top of my head, but the trade deadline should be coming up. I apologize for not knowing it. See if I can get it really quickly. I don't see it, but so look on the do the research on your own to find out when the trade deadline is. But it's coming up. We haven't really had any trades in our league. We have sort of a boring, safe league, myself included. I'm guilty of that. I like to get my guys and stick with it, and it's hard to pull the trigger on a trade, especially this late in the year. So you know, nothing's been decided yet. So get your lineups in. Have a great Turkey Day. I will definitely be talking smack with Matt and Sarah when I see them on Thursday, and maybe, you know, we'll have a little, we're having our annual family flag football game Thursday, so maybe there'll be some smack talking there. So again, you know, email me with any questions, post some comments on the league. I'll try and remember to make this public when I put it on YouTube. I'm not sure why it's automatically going private. But anyway, 14 minutes long rant, but basically 2 weeks worth. So I'm going to sign off now. And again, happy Thanksgiving. Good luck this weekend, everyone. Bye-bye.